governor as an independent, but Tom Ervin says he's a Republican through and through.
And now Ervin, a trial lawyer and former judge, has an ad on the air that takes aim at his Republican rival.
WYFF News 4 Investigates' Tim Waller has tonight's Truth Check report.
It's time for a governor with some guts to tell the truth to the people.
Chances are you have seen this ad. It first hit the airwaves 2 weeks ago, and for many voters, it was their first look at candidate Tom Ervin, the independent running for South Carolina governor.
In South Carolina, your personal financial records have been stolen.
That statement is true. It refers to the big data breach 2 years ago at the South Carolina Department of Revenue. But by putting this in a political ad, Ervin is effectively blaming what happened on incumbent Governor Nikki Haley. Ervin claims Haley botched the investigation by waiting 16 days to let the public know a data breach had occurred and by failing to require other state agencies to beef up their computer security. In fact, only the governor's cabinet agencies were required to upgrade their systems. Other state agencies were urged to do so, and some did, but any changes, they were told, would be at their own expense.
State Department of Social Services turned their backs on abused children.
Whether DSS turned their backs on children is debatable, and here's why. This statement refers to the number of children who have died while under DSS care. 67 last year, 76 the year before. Ervin says those numbers are too high, and he's called on Governor Haley to fire the director of DSS. But Governor Haley insists Lillian Kohler has done a great job. In a recent Facebook post, the governor said she's proud of Kohler for her testimony before a Senate subcommittee concerning problems within DSS and for dramatically improving the Department of Social Services.
Scandals continue to mount. Tom Ervin will end this incompetence.
Even though this ad is currently running, Ervin is not officially on the state ballot. He entered the governor's race in March as a Republican, then withdrew, deciding to run as an independent. But that requires 10,000 signatures by July 15th, which Ervin says he's confident he will get.
Tim Waller reporting for us there. And coming up in our next Truth Check, an ad by Senator Lindsey Graham of South Carolina. Do his claims about Boeing and the National Labor Relations Board hold up? We will find out. And of course, you can see our other Truth Check reports by visiting our website. Just click on the politics under the news tab on WYFF4.com.